Distinguished colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, exactly 70 years ago, representatives of 54 nations gathered in Chicago at the invitation of the United States of America to establish the principles and foundations for an exciting new era of international flight. These diplomats came together in what was then the Stevenson Hotel in Chicago, and indeed in the very same ballroom where I, the Secretary General, and our council colleagues will convene for an extraordinary session of the ICAO Council this 8th of December. We will be joined at this occasion by United Nations Secretary General Ban Ki-moon and many other honored international guests. The resolution we will adopt at this meeting will focus on both the historic and future relevance of the Convention on International Civil Aviation, the landmark global agreement, which is also known more commonly as the Chicago Convention. Forged over 40 days and nights by the 54 diplomatic representatives who had gathered back in 1944 on behalf of their states, the Chicago Convention was in many ways a pioneering achievement. Adopted as it was during a period of terrible global conflict and sacrifice, its drafters had looked to our shared and common sky for a path to peace, and indeed for a new notion of what it meant at the time for states to be sovereign. The preamble to the convention still resonates with the drafters' shared vision that the future development of international civil aviation could greatly help to create and preserve friendship and understanding among the nations and peoples of the world, and further that it will promote the cooperation which must exist between the world's nations and peoples for a true and lasting peace to globally endure. Over the past 7 decades, and with the Convention and its 19 annexes to guide us, ICAO and its now 191 member states have made enormous progress in realizing this vision. Air transport is an essential component of our global society, a powerful driver of economic, social, and cultural development, and the safest and most efficient mode of mass transportation ever created. This is largely the result of commitment of member states to work diligently together through ICAO and with other stakeholders to faithfully implement the provisions of the Chicago Convention and other complementary global civil aviation legal instruments adopted by ICAO. But even as we rejoice in our collective accomplishments and in the historic contributions which have permitted them, we are not the least acutely aware of some challenges ahead of us as well. The exponential growth of the aviation sector will continue in the next decades, and air traffic will double by 2030. While this growth is welcome and promises even greater contribution to the socio-economic prosperity of our nations, it is already placing unprecedented pressure on all members of our community to maintain and enhance the safety, security, and the efficiency of the global air transport system, all while reducing its environmental footprint. There is also pressure to quicken the pace of liberalization and more effectively address the many issues now impacting the economic and commercial viability of modern air transport. And let us not lose sight of the recent proliferation of remotely piloted aircraft systems and the much publicized suborbital flights, which may shortly become much more commonplace. As a community, we have a collective responsibility to ensure that all our member states and stakeholders keep pace with new technological advancements and the standards set in the annexes to the Chicago Convention are implemented in a harmonized manner globally. No country should be left behind, and every passenger should have assurance of a safe, secure, efficient, and reliable air transport service, whatever his or her destination. But of course, challenges are not new to aviation. What is different today compared to 70 years ago is that the world is more interdependent and interconnected than it has ever been. This has created a stronger link of mutual interest among states and the recognition that air transport functions to the great benefit of us all. Therefore, I am confident that through mutual cooperation and support among our member states and industry stakeholders, we will maintain and sustain a strong aviation sector for future generations. So as we reflect together on our modern air transport system, the bridges it has built for us, and the prosperity and development that we have realized by reaching out to one another, let us not forget the founders of the convention, and more importantly, the courage that they had to dream of a different kind of world. Let us build upon the greatness that visionaries such as Edward Warner, Albert Roper, and the many others with them in 1944 were able to achieve. A new and unprecedented scale of global cooperation and trust has been the great legacy of the Chicago Convention. And it is only on the basis of these very same values that we'll be able to realize together our noblest and most enduring potential. I wish you all a happy celebration.